Hi, folks. It's time to leave this place and get to the Woodwright shop. Let's go. Much better. Hi, folks. Welcome to the final class for the Woodwright's Assistance Workshop Show. And after you graduate this class, you'll be ready for the next level of classes, which is finding work as a Woodwright assistant. Just as an aside, I want to assure you that we're not going to waste any time this class. We'll be able to finish our project today, and we'll move on to the next class, as promised. Let's get going. What the heck? I guess this isn't working. I do have a door at the back though, but I don't like to use it. It doesn't work right. But I guess we have no choice, so. It's this way, come on. Like I said, I just don't like using this door. I built it using material from the very first Star Trek episode. You'd best be careful when making them inaccurate statements, because they could lead to an arrest for making libelous remarks. All right. It's not the first Star Trek episode. I just didn't want to go into all that detail because it's just a waste of time. Fine then. If there's no choice but to explain clearly, I guess you'll have to come on with me. It's right over here. Here we go. Ah, this is what I was looking for.
There we go. There we go. Much better.
This isn't going to work. Just a second.
All right, here it is. Just what we were looking for. Yeah. Ah. There we go. All right, come on over, dearie. I've got a story to tell you. That's right. I've got the story about the Star Trek episode, The City on the Edge of Forever. And here it is, The City on the Edge of Forever, the second Star Trek episode, after the first pilot episode, which was called The Cage, which was then republished as a two-parter. But this one here is all about Captain Kirk, who goes about his business, goes flying through the space, and he gets into... There's McCoy. Oh no, the Thorazine! I had the Thorazine! He's not feeling well. He escapes. He goes out. Scotty goes, oh no, there's the Guardian. Where's Scotty gone?
Captain, Scotty has gone. Captain McCoy, we need to go in there, the change of time. So we must go in, Captain. But I don't know what to do. That can't be. So then he jumps through the Guardian. And there it is, the Guardian. The Guardian that goes through time and space in all sorts of different places.
So there you have it. I've used the Guardian lumber from the set of the Star Trek episode, and I used it to build this door. I never knew what was going on. I didn't expect any problems, but there they are. So the door works a little weird. Anyways, let's go on in, and hopefully everything will be fine.
no.
I really don't want to take a chance on doing it a third time. Last time I did that, I ended up in some shop in some other city, so I had to take a train to get back home. And I really don't want to waste that time. So I guess we could try the front again. There's another way we could maybe get in there, so let's go there. It's right here, the garage door. I don't like using this one either, but not for the same reason. It's a garage. Finally in. Time to begin on our...
What?
Mahna-Mahna. 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 Mahna-Mahna.
So before working on the project, it's important to talk about safety issues. So wearing these clothes, it's a bit dangerous around the garage, so we have to change into our garage clothing. Normally I change my pants, but as you can see, I've got a stain on them. It's duct tape adhesive, which comes from a prior time when I was trying to do something that was useful for my knees, but it didn't quite work. I remember how it happened.
Crawling on all fours like this is going to get me filthy. My suit's going to be ruined. I think I need to do some protection.
Duct tape is wonderful, but the adhesive is something else. Say, most of you have probably been wondering about where duct tape gets its name. Some of you might be thinking it's spelt D-U-C-T because it gets wrapped around ducts. Some of you may think it's spelt duck,
D-U-C-K,
because it was used to wrap ducks and keep them dry during the Great War. But I know the real reason. If this has ever happened to you, then you know why it's called duct tape. So back to safety. As I was saying, you can't wear your work clothes in the garage. You have to wear your garage clothes. Otherwise, it just wouldn't be safe. Oh, need a coat hanger here just a sec. Now for the garage clothes. Oh.
That's much better. Good old garage clothing. Now, just got a fun place to hang this up.
No, that's just too dusty. That's not much better. There's just no way. It's just too dusty. I've got to go hang this in the house.
All I want to do is build a project. That's it. That's too much to ask. Just to do one project in one day, I just don't think it's that much. Every time I do this, it just never ends. I just want to do the project. It's just...
There!
So we're back. Welcome to the Woodwright's Assistant class, and let's go in and do our project.
So today's project is to build an antique-style toolbox to replace the one that you've been using so far, the one you got from the dollar store. So to start your project, you need to make a plan, and I've got some ready already here in my pockets.
I've got them in here, and I'm sure if I would be... Yeah, there you go.
There we go.
There, I've unfolded these, and you've got these different types, and this one here is a calculation for a formula, and you've got to get it done, and then there's the shapes that you've got to cut out with the thing of the EH there, and this one's a receipt. So without the receipt, we've got these plans here that we can examine, and maybe there's a simpler way of looking at this. I have an exploded diagram of this that I could show you. I've got it over here. Let me get.
It's in here somewhere. I've got it. There it is.
There it is. An exploded diagram of the thing for you.
Now that we know what we're building, let's get some wood for it.
I've got it in my storage out back here. The shorter pieces are in the back over here.
So we're here again. Welcome to the Woodwright's Assistant Class Workshop Show. Come on in, let's get the wood cut.
So first things first, we're going to have to drill some pilot holes, and for that we're going to need my drill. So let's go find my drill.
This is where it should be. There's nothing in there. What's going on?
No, it's not here. No.
A quick point for our Woodwright's assistants. You should always put your tools away.
So you take your drill, you put your bit in, and you put it over here, and you just drill. What's going on? It's not going in. It's just not going... Oh.
Another stupid point. When you're drilling holes, you should have always put your drill in forward.
Of course, if you're like me and you work in a garage that's open to the air, you have a problem with mosquitoes. So before you start working, you need to get some mosquito coils. Now for me, I have some fond memories of these mosquito coils when I was a child.
I remember it like it was just a few minutes ago.
Mommy, Mommy Pig, Mommy.
Stop that, you silly child.
Please, Mommy, please pick. I want to pick coils. Please, Mommy. Mommy, Mommy Pig, Mommy.
Here you go, you silly child.
Thank you, Mommy.
Another thing I remember with pick coils was using them to light little roll caps to burn spider webs when I was a child. But single cap explosions were too small. I had to go bigger, louder. Of course, I always waited for my parents to be gone to do my experiments, but unfortunately after the hammer and roll incident, I was ratted out by a neighbor and I was caught, my rolls were confiscated, and I was punished. I couldn't let things sit like that. I had to up the ante. I had connections on the black market and was able to secure one final roll of caps. So, if the hammer thing had worked, what about this?
Remember, kids, leave this for trained professionals. Don't try this at home.
The thing about the vice is the tension. You never know when the thing's gonna blow. I can't stand it!
Enough of these fond memories. Anyway, let's get this coil going and we can start on our project. Alright, now that we've got our mosquito coil going, let's get back to drilling some wood. Whatever you do, don't press the red button or the world will end! Wait! I'm not falling for that. That's one of those stupid guardian time loops. They happen at least twice a day. Best thing to do is just ignore them. You know what this reminds me of? Tool abuse. That's right, tool abuse. I'm reminded of a friend of mine I was just visiting the other day, and his son Maxwell. These guys are unbelievable. They abuse their tools like you wouldn't believe. One day they were working in the barn, and they were cutting firewood. And the father was holding an axe head. The handle was broken long ago, and he was holding it like this. And the son had a 9-pound hammer, and he was hitting the axe head with a 9-pound hammer. Unfortunately, the 9-pound hammer's handle was also broken, so they had a short stick that he'd stuck into it. So I'm working outside the barn, and all of a sudden I hear this scream, "Help, help, help!" And I go out there, and I get there, And the father is like, you can imagine, you know, the son went whoosh like this with the hammer. The hammer head went flying off the handle, and it fell flat on his head. So he's standing there, you know, like this. You know, have you ever seen a guy with noodle legs? Well, I just saw them there. Let me tell you, it was funny. We were each holding him, and his legs were just wobbling underneath, you know. So we put him down on the ground. He's lying there, his eyes closed, you know. So his wife comes out, you know, and he says, "Oh, are you all right? Are you all right?" And he's going, "Yes, yes, yes, just let me get up and get a cigarette." So he gets up, and he's walking towards the house, and he goes to get his cigarette, and the wife hands him the lighter, and his fingers are all numb from the shock, you know? So he fumbles the lighter, and he drops it. So he goes, "Oh," and he bends down to pick it up, and the wife goes, "Oh, I'll get it there," like this, and they smack their heads together. And of course, I burst out laughing. What else could I do? You know. Anyways, the moral of that story is you've always got to be careful of the son Maxwell's little hammer, silver or not. Anyway, let's get back to the project. Darn, look at the time. We've run out of time again. I can't believe it. Oh well. Sorry guys, I guess we'll have to schedule another class for finishing the project. And but the next class will be the last class, I promise. And then you could graduate and get on to becoming a Woodwright's assistant proper. Anyway, so thanks for coming today, and we hope to see you again soon.
Mahna-Mahna. 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 Mahna-Mahna.